Hey everybody, so back for more La-Mulana. So there were a couple of things that had come up for me that I've been thinking about since I had last played yesterday. So one of those things pertained to this giant machine, and I'm kind of curious at least to take a look at that. So one of the things that I had noted when I took a look at my notes was this one that says the five rays of light are the origin of creation. Move the light and create. So all of these correspond with the kind of stuff that's in the Brahma dialogues that talks about their their respective colors when Brahma is talking to, like, the gods, the other gods. So or not talking to the other gods, but when I showed the egg to the other deity statues, so when I interacted with Chaos, that was the blue light that came out. And then Ymir was yellow. Mina Kanushi was red. And so on, basically. So yeah, what was this one? Atom, assuming the form of a green snake before leaving for battle, creation is fighting to protect. So I'm wondering if there are actually some things in here that actually tie in, and whether or not I'm able to manipulate where the lights are shining. Because a lot of them kind of say things that are possibly relevant to the whole virtue yuga stuff, but then I don't know. You know, Brahma asked Amino Mina Kanushi, "What is creation?" Illuminated all with a red light. The lives born from that are creation. So he illuminated all. So I wanted to basically come in here and then open this up. I don't know whether or not I'm going to really kind of try hard in terms of shifting these around, but like, I can't scan these. Ah, but I can attack them, and that changes which one they're going for. So I can manipulate these colors. So this thing makes makes it all very, very much so more complex. So for example, let's see, what shall be placed on this arm is such a yuga of that which represents the age of blessing. So this was supposed to be because this is something that I actually have something of a hint of above this one. So the Age of Blessing, Satyayuga, is the Gold Age, when all virtue is overflowing. So for this, This is the Padma Lotus, which represents blessing. And it's the Gold Age. So... so this is set here. Gold, when all virtue is overflowing. So we have the most number of hooves. But then... like, that's... yeah. Like, which... which colors should I go with? I mean, this is kind of goldish. Am I just going by color, or am I actually going with these hints that the creation dialogues get at? So, it's the Gold Age, all virtue is overflowing. I've completely lost my place. So, Abzu talks about creation being... Abzu was begotten of pure waters. So, he answered that undefiled clear waters. I mean, it also doesn't really make sense to me in the sense... so, I can create gold using some of these colors, but how do I go about creating, like, silver from these? Like... maybe... that this is just going to be, like, white. But then how do I do, like, steel now blunted? Would it just be the black? I don't really know. I mean, I suppose it's something that I could experiment with. I know when I was screwing around before, all of the little things that were coming down came down with, like, a golden outline with some sort of skull face in the center of it. So, yeah. I don't really know. Yeah, like, that's the same symbol, which makes me feel as though that's wrong. Well, I'm happy to have discovered that I can at least move these things around. Now I have a hell of a lot more to think about, though. So, Satya Yuga is the Age of Blessing. This is supposed to be the Lotus Flower. Golden Age, where all virtue is overflowing. Is there anything else that I had read about that? No, it just says Satya Yuga is the Gold Age when all virtue is overflowing. Let's see. Upara Yuga, the Age of Copper, when disaster was wrought from virtue and sin imbalance. Kali Yuga, steel now blunted, the age where virtue disappeared, replaced by conflict and despair. But I'm not really seeing the, like, stuff in the creation dialogues about some of this other kind of language that would give me some hint as to which colors should go in which directions. Maybe... Maybe I should go back and examine some of the... some of the actual statues. So it's an easy one to get to. So I'll go look at Amino Mina Kanushi. This cat. While I'm here. So, Amino Mina Kanushi bears a striking resemblance to Amino Mina Kanushi. I would hope a statue of Amino Mina Kanushi would bear a striking resemblance to Amino Mina Kanushi. One of the Kikoto Amatsu gods of Japanese mythology's creation myth, said to have been the first of the race, making them one of the first of any race to exist. That doesn't really help me. How about in the Dark Star Lord's Pyramid? This is the Hall of Malice. Much better. Satan bears a striking resemblance to the god of creation of Egyptian mythology, Atum, a creation deity who is self-begotten from primeval waters before creating other gods in turn. I mean, not really. Check in the mirror just to. I don't know. Be thorough, I suppose. Stone statue thought to be of Ymir, the Norse mythology proto-being. The myths tell of how he was defeated by his own children, how the world came to be from his dissected body parts, and how dwarves corresponding to the four cardinal points held his skull aloft, creating the sky. Yeah, I don't know about that. So how... How did the various colors attach to the Yuga? Or to the items themselves? let's have a look at the Divine Fortress and the Yuga Disc that's up there. Give me that. Actually, I'm not full. That's good. So, a ring with the diagram that represents the 4.32 million year cycle the world undergoes, split into four ages. These four ages are known as the Satya Yuga, the Treta Yuga, Dvapara Yuga, and Kali Yuga. Lotus flower is depicted in the center of the ring. I wonder if the ordering here is important at all. Or the ordering on the disc, for that matter. Doesn't seem to suggest anything here. And I'm quite sure all the other two discs that I've seen also rotate clockwise and have the same like orientation of like gold, silver, bronze, steel, bronze, silver, gold. This doesn't seem to give any clues as to that. Let me quickly take a look at the one in the shrine. Just to examine any differences. Like, right, I'm not going there. Yeah, Abzu. Thought to be the freshwater sea within chaos from which the various gods are born. I mean, this kind of... Well... I mean, it talks about, like, seas and that sort of thing. In the dialogue, just whether or not that's important to the Yuga is the question. Or in what way? So yeah, this one's rotating the same way, looks the same way. Also orders them in Satya, Treta, Dvapara, and Kali Yuga. Sacred text is drawn in the center of the ring. Ooh la la. Yeah. Five rays of light are the origin of creation. Move the light and create. Move the light and create. Damn. I wanted to read that tablet again. I know it's the one that, it's the one giving the hints about the yuga and that kind of thing, but... Take that! Wasn't this one, was it? Okay. I skimped some on my note about the Padma Lotus. Or did I? Maybe I've just skimped on writing it in this particular section. Da-da-da, where is this? Yeah, there it is. The Padma Lotus begets blessing, but blessings will not grace those for whom life is tangled with chaos. Okay. So... Let me... Where's this page? Where are my creation dialogues? Okay, so, in greater detail, so, Padma Lotus begets blessing, but blessings will not grace those for whom life is tangled with chaos. I think originally when I had read this, I was thinking that had something to do with, like, mantras and alternate meanings or something like that, but I think this has to do with this. So... Let's see... So Brahma asked Amino Minokanushi what is creation. Amaterasu illuminated all with a red light. The lives born from that are creation. So is that life? So life would be associated perhaps with a red light? And then Brahma asked Chaos, what is creation? Chaos responded only by existing. Creation is simply floating in the purple darkness. But when I scanned Chaos, it was a blue light? Let me take another look at the machine. Ah! Excuse me. Excuse me, come through. No, that's not what I was looking for. What was the other one? Because I had the... Yeah, Bapara Yuga represents the age of tolerance, the Kamandola water pot. Nah, I took that note somewhere else. It wasn't in here. What was this? Oh, oh. Right. So the Kamandola water pot, I think I took that note in the underworld. Let me have a quick look. Here it is. So, we have. God damn it! I'm dumb. All right, so. The Kamandolu water pot. Is tolerance. It is the vessel which will tolerate any battle that provokes chaos. And then Brahma asked Atum what is creation. Atum answered by assuming the form of green snake before leaving for battle. Creation is fighting to protect. So that would be green. Any battle that provokes chaos. Yeah, chaos responded only by existing. Creation is simply floating in the purple darkness. That was a blue light. So, there are a couple of things that are clear. One, I'm feeling as though I'm starting to get some kind of handle on what this puzzle is driving at. And the second thing that's clear is I don't have enough information to solve this. But I kind of want to play around with just this to see if I'm on the right track. So life is tangled with chaos. So okay, so let's take a look. So, the Kamandolu water pot is tolerance, which is Vipara Yuga, which represents the age of tolerance. So that's Trichi Yuga. I'll get out of the way here. So this is the Age of Tolerance, right here. And the Age of Tolerance is... wrought from virtue and sin in balance. So here we have this one. So virtue and sin in balance. And then it is the vessel which will tolerate any battle that provokes chaos. So Atum answered by assuming the form of a green snake before leaving for battle. So green. And any battle that provokes chaos. Chaos responded only by existing. Creation is simply floating in the purple darkness. So let's go with purple. So virtue and sin and balance, green and purple for battle and chaos. The Kamandolu water pot. Okay. Very cool. Very, very cool. But, yeah. So yeah, I think I have a pretty good handle on what I'm supposed to do. Problem is that I don't have enough information. I don't have enough information for the others. At least I don't think so. I didn't. Because there's the lotus, the water pot, there is the sacred text. And I haven't found the fourth one. So I don't know what the fourth ring is. For the Age of Kali Yuga. So I need to find that. And I need to find two more tablets telling me what lights are, you know, what beams or rays of creation to use to spawn that. But I know what virtues are corresponding with each individual one. Although, it's a bit, it kind of doubles up in a sense on the puzzle, because it gives you the hint about the ox hooves, but then it just gives you a face, and the face has, like, gold and copper and, like, a silvery and a steel thing, so it's almost like they're giving you two hints for the same thing. They're just, like, displaying, like, the age as well as the ox hooves. Oh, whatever. I'm gonna sit here and be like, you've made this puzzle too easy. But yeah, so I need to at least find two more tablets that are going to tell me about the sacred text. No, I do not. The Veda texts constitute a belief system. One belief is that when we reach death, we will return to water. So I have that one. Because death and water, so I'm so certain this is one of them. So the Veda texts constitute a belief system. One belief is that when we reach death, we return to water. So this is, or these correspond, so water is Abzu, Zabuzu, begotten of pure water, so he answered that undefiled, clear water is our creation. And then death, I think, would be associated with Ymir. The glimmer of that which is birthed from death is creation. So that would be blue and yellow. Okay. So that accounts for three. So I should be able to spawn the lotus flower, the sacred text, the Kamandolu water pot. But I'm not even sure what the fourth one is, for the Age of Steel now blunted. It's possible that I've run across some tablet that describes this thing, but I didn't know what it means. Kind of similar to prior to my epiphany seconds ago, about the Veda texts, because I've read over that a number of times, and I'm like, what the crack is this talking about? And I never thought about it in that sense. So it's definitely possible that I've already read, despite the fact that I haven't seen, like, the Yuga disc. I've only seen three of them, so I don't know what's inside the fourth Yuga disc. But it's possible that I've already come across it, and I just didn't know. Repeating myself now. I'm not sure I really want to go through here right this second, though, and, like, delve through all of my notes, and I'm like, which ones? Could be this one. I don't know where this tablet is. There are as many mala prayer beads as worldly desires. The beads weave together those whose desires drive them to fight tirelessly, even after their lives are exhausted. But I don't know. Worldly desires, Kali Yuga. Yep, I don't know. I'd like to know where that was, though. Because I'd love to look at the tablet, but I don't. It's the Immortal Battlefield? Maybe I will go have a look at it real quick. Real quick. So it was, I think I know the room that the tablet is in, because I've written it next to the, the tablet that simply says believe. And the tablet that says believe is like, below me here. Like, this is the one that says believe. Ow. Jerk. Which would suggest to me, at least, that the tablet I'm thinking about is in this room? Yeah, there are as many mala prayer beads as worldly desires. The beads weave together those whose desires drive them to fight tirelessly even after their lives are exhausted. So fight might indicate... Atem, the form of a green snake before leaving for battle, and then lives, would be red. I wonder if I can actually do this right now. I mean, it's funny, because it's like I haven't seen the damn thing, but... Like, I really get the sense that this is maybe what it ties into. Why don't I try this? I'll put a big question mark here in my notes in case this doesn't work. So... Many mala prayer beads as worldly desires, the beads weave together those whose desires drive them to fight tirelessly. Even after their lives are exhausted. Okay. Let's go to Brahma. It's funny, I wasn't actually expecting to do this when I started recording. I was thinking, I'll maybe screw around the room, see if I can move the lights around, and then I'll go on and do... I wanted to go back to the... What was it? I'm actually really low on health. So I'll do this. Yeah, like I wanted to go back to the Heaven's Labyrinth and poke around a little bit more. With some of the tablets or hints that I'd received there. Try and see if I could get my hands on the cog. And then I was going to go to the underworld and start mapping it. Which I continue to put off. Okay. So I could be wrong about this, but... It's like... I mean, put it this way. So, you could call it, like, process of elimination. The way that I'm thinking about it is, like... There's only so many degrees of freedom, and I have three of them, which means that there's none left. So either this Mala Prayer Bead tablet actually corresponds with what's going on here, or, you know, it doesn't. So, the Golden Age, Satyayuga, the Age of Blessing. Let's do this one first. So, maybe I'll make myself very small. Woo! All right. That's way too small. All right. I just didn't want to like block up part of the screen if it was important. Right. So. life and chaos, so red and purple for this one. So purple's already there. So let's get red moved over here. So that's life and chaos and boop. There's my lotus flower. So here we have Tretiyuga, the Age of Belief. And I think this is correct. When virtue declined, and people came to lean on ceremony. Yeah. Yeah, because the other one is when virtue disappeared. So this is definitely the Silver Age that I've selected here. Which is this one, Tretiyuga. Right. Come on. Where the hell did I put this crap? Yeah. Tretiyuga. Okay. So, with that being the case, then. The Veda texts constitute a belief system. One belief is that when we reach death, we return to water. So, blue and yellow. So, yellow's already here. So, this should be the sacred texts. And it is. Next is Vaparayuga, the Age of Tolerance. This is the Kamandola Water Pot, which I already did, which is any battle that provokes chaos. So this will be green for battle. Not you. And purple, because that's chaos. So this is the Water Pot. Okay. There are as many mala prayer beads as worldly desires. The beads weave together those whose desires drive them to fight. Also, we need to change this over. Where virtue disappeared, the Age of Steel now blunted. Kali Yuga. See? That which represents the Age of Worldly Desires. So there are as many mala prayer beads as worldly desires. This is totally it. So fight tirelessly even after their lives are exhausted. So it's not this, it is red. Very cool. Oh. You passed Brahma's trials with flying colors. Hey! I wonder what that's a picture of. Could it be a full map of La-Mulana? What are those red and blue lights? They probably represent certain locations. Try checking it against the map on your tablet. You may figure something out. So this is what Toth is talking about. I've heard tales of a map containing the locations of all of the mantras. It is said that the location of the mantras still lying dormant, glow red on this map. Okay. So what the hell? There's like one all the way out here. I don't have to draw this, do I? Oh god. Please tell me I can scan it. Okay. So shit, my weakness! Okay. I suppose I could just take like a screenshot or something, but then I don't know. And there's nothing further down here, is there? No. Okay. Let's just do that a little bit, and then, let's see, I'm going to print screen here. Don't worry, there's nothing hidden behind the camera here. Okay. So that'll be my map. So the other thing that's coming up here is that it's like, okay, well then, how do I interpret the map? I suppose the best thing to do would be to think about... So the ones that are in blue are likely the mantras that I've already... the ones that I know. So there's 7 of these. But there's only 4 blue lights. So that doesn't stack up. Okay. So I maybe have no idea what the blue lights mean then. But... probably delete these now. This one I'm like slightly weirded out because it's like Shiva sits in the heavens from which he drops the light that burns the land below. And I'm kind of like, not sure I've run across that one. But yeah, I mean... location of mantra still lying dormant, glow red on the map. It's gotta be what this means, right? The interesting thing here is that I've seen parts of this map on tablets in areas. So... this area here in the center, where you have, like, the circle, and then there's, like, the helical symbol in the middle. I am pretty sure that I've seen that on a tablet somewhere. And I feel like I've seen other parts of these tablets in other areas. So it might be a clue in terms of what areas have mantras or where. I'm also interested in... the different lines that are, like, connecting around to various parts of the tree. And whether or not that corresponds with the corridor of blood connections. Also, I have to remember the stuff that... that Mulbrick had to say with respect to, like, Yggdrasil, the world's tree is, like, upside down. So when I was looking into the trying to fight Vidofnir, like the treetop is at the lowest point on the map because it's the highest point. So I need to keep that in mind. With respect to what I'm doing there. Because I think the idea from this is that you're... like, it's supposed to illuminate, hey, these are areas that you've already been to. And because you've already been to these areas, you know, like, it's giving you some sort of clue as to, you know, hey, there's a mantra here. But now I need to sort of decipher this. Which... maybe I'll make... it's like one of these things where I'm like, do I want to tackle this now? Or do I want to investigate some of the other things that I have wanted to investigate? And that's the real kicker. Here's the interesting thing, though. Like, what does this do now? Why don't I go and save it? Excuse me. All the electricity. So what does this do? Whoa. Hey, you can see, so right here, right up here, you can, it's hard to point with my camera, because like, yeah, anyway. So you can actually see the Infernal Beast, like right up here, and you can see it eating the Colossal Dragon's head. But where is that? So this ties in with the other things that I was wanting to do, right? The Infernal Fiend bites into the neck of the Colossal Dragon, thus binding them together. Incant at the Colossal Dragon's neck. Heaven and earth grind fire and wind flow into the sea. These words will lean you into the Infernal Fiend's jaw. So where the fuck is that? And then we have more of other stuff. And also... wait, but like the lights are changing positions. Right? Fuck me. So it's like, okay, hang on. I don't want to waste all of my weights flipping around these things. So... so some of these are glowing white, like the one at the bottom and the one at the top up here. This right here looks like Abzu. The one up at the top looks like Odin's birds. The ones that I fought like super early on in the game. Like the ravens that were protecting like the origin seal. And then I don't know about these two down here, but they could be representing the ones in the, like in the treetop. Because that was another pair of birds. Oh, man. And then what do we have here? Just lots of stuff I don't understand. So the question is, like, where is this part of the map? Like, right in this area right here. I suppose one of the best things to do would be to go through and scan some of those tablets, looking for some of these symbols, and seeing what areas they're associated with. I'm just quickly gonna quit out so that I can get my bloody weights back. Because I've just spent, like, 6 of them. But yeah. So that at least gives me some information as to this whole incanting at the colossal dragon's neck. So this is associated with some part of some area. You know, wherever this part is. But I don't know where that is. So I need to go looking, essentially. Does it show on these? Yeah, so you can see, there's like that weird bird thing. So this should show. Oh man. I get the feeling this is gonna be like the snake lady because that's Echidna. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I think this is how. I am gonna need to create a map. Oh god. Okay. So yeah. Yeah. I think what I'm going to do is that. Alright. It just keeps going. Alright. So the I don't know. I'll call them corresponding like constellations. It's almost like a little star map. So the constellations match like Grail tablet iconography. So I want to create a map from that, and then from there I'll be able to determine those areas where I have dormant mantras. The question that I had, though, so basically I'm making a little bit of a, actually you can see it pop up during the warp. Okay. So here's the question that I have. So I have 4. So this is part of what made sense to me. Actually, it doesn't make any sense to me now. Because I have 7 of the mantras, and yet there are 4 icons here denoting dormant mantras. So maybe it's not that they're... Maybe the map isn't showing me where I can get the mantras, it's showing me where I need to, like, chant them? Or something? So I've got one here, and then one, like, fucking way off up there. I have another down here. And then more up there. But yeah, you can see these symbols right here. So this one was the one that I was scanning here in the Ancient Chaos. And then up here, this is the symbol in the Hall of Malice. Is there overlap on these, though? There kind of is. Even more confusing. Oh, man. The unfortunate thing is that I don't have all of the time that I'd really like to work on this today. I was actually planning on making this a little bit shorter, which is why I'm making a note for myself, like... Pardon me. I have to do this later. Because again, like I was sort of alluding to, you know, my thought was that, oh, I'll see if the lights work, and then, oh, I'll have to go somewhere else, because I won't be able to solve this. So there's the Infernal Fiend. The wake of the Infernal Fiend that lusts for the Mother's power. This is the Takamagahara Shrine, a land buried by the walls of those who have closed their hearts off to others. That's the Colossal Dragon. It actually kind of looks like it. You know, like you've got the wing up there and then you've got like the head. Now I'm really suspicious. I haven't made the map, but I'm like... Oh. I want fairy. Fairy I want. Whistle at that. Where is this? Olympian? I just gotta know, dude. Heaven and earth grind fire, wind flown to the sea. Dude. Dude! Give me that cog! Ow. Please stop. Okay, don't hit me in the face. An artifact that appears to be some kind of ancient cog. Press the item button to slot it into its rightful place. Oh boy, I've cracked open a lot right now. So... Shit. Oh, man. Yeah. Okay, so that addresses Yeah, like that actually covers all of the things that I wanted to do in terms of Infernal Fiend biting into the neck of the Colossal Dragon. Done the incantation there. I mean, originally I had written down here, Gygas sealed in these lands, which I wrote down in the Heaven's Labyrinth. Their ensealment is entrusted entirely to Typhon. And I was thinking, like I need the cog in order to get... Like, there's the cog thing in the Hall of Malice. So I was thinking, you know, does that unseal the Gygas? So then do I need to investigate more into Typhon? Which is what I'd written down here. And then I also wrote down this one, proceed down the path where backs face each other, because I wasn't sure I really fully figured that one out. Because there's like certain different impacts that I had when you move the celestial disc a certain number of times, but I couldn't remember if there was anything special that I had done when you move it like twice, which is I think how you got the backs facing each other. So, okay. Oh, man. Yeah, so the only thing that I think that I would want to maybe jump on that I possibly had time for left was just mapping out the underworld and all of the doors in there. But I don't... I probably don't have time for that right now anyway. And then on top of that, there's like all of this new stuff that I now have open. Because now I have the cog, and there are so many different places that I can use it. I can use it in the Takamagahara Shrine, I can use it in the Pit of Time, which then opens up even more stuff, because then I get the item to control time there, presumably. And, you know, it seems kind of obvious. Because then I can start talking to Alvis, and getting, like, the hidden meanings behind some of the mantras, which then opens up even more stuff for me to cover. And then there's the cog in the Hall of Malice. So yeah, I don't have time to do those things today. So... I'm actually interested, though. Now that I've... Oh, shit. I'll spend a couple of weights with this little experiment. So now that I've chanted there, this one hasn't changed as far as I can tell. Yeah. So, I'm pretty sure this one... I think it was red before? Actually, I don't know. Fuck. I might have to go back and just, like, quickly review the footage to see, like, if my having chanted in this room right here has actually done anything in that respect. But yeah, I'll have to do that on another day. So here's I'm gonna have to make some decisions about what I want to do next time that I stream. Because so the part of me that wants to be thorough, I really want to go to the underworld and map that out. I also really want to create a map of Yggdrasil based on those different displays and scanning of the Grail tablets and doing all of that kind of stuff. Because that's, like, it's more preparatory work. I almost wonder if I could just do that off stream, but I probably won't. Maybe the Yggdrasil map. I might do that off stream, but mapping out the underworld in terms of exploring various doors and where do they take me and stuff like that, I might do on stream. I probably will do on stream. So those are the things that I'm like, I really should do those. Yet the things that I want to do are just like, oh man, I've cracked open so much. Charge! And go forward with anything relating to the ancient cog or things that that unlocks. And because the fact of the matter is that I've been wanting to and working toward trying to get that. And now that it's happened, I'm like, I gotta do it. So I'll think about what I want to do. And then I'll make some decision when I record next. I'll figure it out. Oh man, that was way more productive than I thought that this was actually going to be. Like, way more productive. Honestly, I thought I was going to play around with the lights, and then I was just going to do some mapping, and it was going to be pretty boring. But a lot of things happened, so it's cool. So anyway, I'll see you next time for something, whatever that'll be. So, have a good one.